Well, a local man is going on the run of a lifetime.
Earlier this morning, Julissa Ortiz met up with a marathon runner who's taken on the world's toughest foot race.
We are about to introduce you to a local guy who is about to go on a race, 135 miles, that takes him through Death Valley. Can you believe that? And it's not the first time. Take a look around. All of these medals and trophies, all indicating a race that is literally, you've gone around the world to do this. You are the ultra marathon runner. Ray Sanchez, good morning to you.
Good morning.
I gotta know, what is it about running these? I mean, we're not just talking a marathon of 26 miles. We're talking over, like this next one you're about to do at Badwater is 135 miles. What is it about these long runs that you enjoy so much?
The challenge.
The challenge.
Yes.
Yeah. You have not, this is not your first time doing this, so this will be your 13th.
13th time.
Oh my gosh. How long will it take you to, or has it taken you to do this, and what are you hoping for this next time?
I've ranged anywhere from, my best time is 27 to about 40 hours. Mm-hmm. So I'm shooting to break 27 this year.
Oh my gosh. What are you thinking about? What gets you through those tough miles?
I mean, there's times where you're just running and, it's like, wow, I just did 25 miles.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, wow, you don't feel it. But then there's times where, you know, you get, you know, you're trying to get to the like, in this race, I'm trying to get to the car, and it's like a mile, and it takes forever. I mean, you're sitting there, and you get there, but it seems like it's like an hour or two just, you know, to get a couple yards.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Amazing. All right. We have some of the gear that you are going to be taking with you. You have a crew, right?
Yes.
These are the people that are going to be really alongside you, supporting you along the way. This is some of the stuff that you actually, your nutrition.
Nutrition, yes.
So it's all liquid.
It's mainly majority of it's liquid. Okay. I'll have like one or two couple of power bars I'll be taking, the hammer ones.
Okay. You said you're not superstitious, but you tend to go with the long sleeve shirts, the thin ones.
Because it kind of protects you more from the sun, from sunburn. At the same time, as you sweat, when the wind hits you, it kind of cools you down a lot
more. I see you're wearing some flip-flops now, but you don't do that. How many pairs of shoes do you take with you?
I'll take probably about two.
Two?
Yeah, just because your feet swell up, so you got to take a bigger size.
Oh, okay.
And then switch out.
Okay. Let's see. That's your spray bottle, so your crew will be keeping you cool along the way.
My crew will be right behind me. They'll be spraying me down to keep me wet, but they don't just spray me. They got to spray me a certain way because I don't want water to run down where I get chafing or just stop me. Because I had that before where I end up, I mean, you can't even run.
Right, right. Oh my goodness. Okay, and what is your, after you just finished the race, what's the meal you got to have?
Pizza.
I love it. I love it. Okay, and on a cheat day, what's the dessert of choice?
Dessert, M&M's.
I feel like you've earned more than a bag of M&M's, right?
Oh, I eat a lot of M&M's.
Oh my gosh. Well, we wish you the very best. July 19th. And of course, after all of this, you are hoping to bring these long runs here to the Folsom area. You've got SS Mountain Racing. So you're hoping to bring Folsom 100 in the near future.
Yes, I'll be having that. Hopefully, I'll have that next May, the second week of May. I'll be having that here with a 200.
Okay, all right. Well, I will be along the sidelines cheering you on. But if anyone is interested, of course, we've got the website linked up to ours. Again, the Badwater Race starting on July 19th. We'll be cheering Ray on as well.